Hey everyone, welcome back to another Redmi Note 7 Pro's interesting features video. I have already made several videos about the Redmi Note 7 as well as Redmi Note 7 Pro or mobile photography in general. So if in case you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and as well as like and share this video in order to support our channel. So here's the Redmi Note 7 Pro, continuing the features. Today we'll be looking at how to use the one-handed mode. So in order to enable one-handed mode, you have to go to the settings, and inside the settings, additional settings. So here's the additional settings, and here you'll find one-handed mode. Where it is? Here it is. So just tap on that. As you can see, it shows with its animation and how you can actually use the one-handed mode. So there are three options here: 3.5 inches, 4 inches, 4.5 inches, depending on how you're holding your mobile, depending on how large your hands is, you can use the one-handed mode. Just turn on the switch. And basically, if I do it like this, as you can see, I have selected 4.5 inches. So the screen is of 4.5 inches. Unfortunately, you cannot customize the size as per your needs, but still there are three options. I think that's more than enough for most of the users. So 3.5 inches, as you can see how it is changing. You can use it just with one-handed mode for emergency purposes. So this is switched right away from here. So if you want to go back to the normal mode, just tap on the dark area and boom, you have the full screen mode here. So this is how you use the one-handed mode. You can just swipe like this in order to go if you are left-handed user. So this is how you customize the one-handed mode. The next setting we'll be looking is launching camera with a single button, or rather gesture. So in order to do that, let's go to the settings which we are already in. So inside the additional settings, you will find button and gesture shortcuts. Just go here and launch camera. By default, it is selected to none, as you can see. This is very nifty feature. Quickly you can launch the camera from your screen even if you have locked the screen. So you can choose from various options available here. Let's say double press the power button. So if I keep the double press the power button, even if I have locked the screen, if I just double press the power button, instantly camera should open, as you can see here. So this is a very quick way of launching the camera, and you don't have to miss any frame when you are trying to capture any scenario. So this way you can quickly launch the camera using the shortcut gesture, double press the power button. You can also customize as per your liking. So this is a quick shortcut button that we have set for the launching of camera. So the next setting is again inside the buttons and gesture here. So here you'll find the split screen. So open split screen. So as you can see, long press the home button, long press the menu button, long press the back button. So whichever is convenient for you, you can keep the, let's say I keep the long press the back button, and if I just tap and hold the back button, split screen is here. So I can access the browser and I can still do a lot of things with the split screen. So you can resize as per your needs. As you can see, I can resize it. So this is how you use the split screen. So by default, it won't be enabled. So you have to go to the settings here and then enable it. So in order to exit, there is exit icon here. Just tap on that and boom, there you go. So open split screen by long pressing the back button. You can use that. Otherwise, you can use this recent app and go from here. Just tap and hold, or rather even here it is split screen, just tap on that and you can enable the split screen. So there are a lot of different ways, but the quickest means is to set the any of the button to open the split screen. Next thing we are going to look at is how you can actually change the display size. So in order to change the display size, what you have to do is go to the settings again. Right now we are in settings. Here you will find accessibility. So even what you can do is just inside the search settings, you can just type the accessibility. So here comes the accessibility, which is located in additional settings. So guys, in the accessibility, what you can do is increase the display size. So right now it is set to default. Now let's say I make it small, and it's kind of like it gives you a feel of having a very large phone and with very, very nice resolution. So that's very important. So if you like this kind of interface, as you can see, if I go back to home screen, everything is changed, and it sort of actually looks nice when you are using this large phone to do a lot of tasks. Everything is small here, everything is laid out very nicely, as you can see, all tiny screen. So if you are a person who want the display size to be even larger, you can actually change that by moving from default to changing it to large, extra large. You can also tap on plus icon here, so large, extra large. So this is how you can change the font size as well as the entire display size itself by changing from here. So the next setting is, again, inside the settings you'll find the privacy. So let's go to the privacy here. I can either move down and select privacy, otherwise directly we can just type over the setting that we are looking to. So here's the privacy, which is again located in additional settings. So settings, additional settings, and again privacy. Here you have special app access. Now here's the thing, let's say if you want some of the application to be kept to default. So if you want to change the default, you can right away change here, and there are so many things that you can actually customize here. Let's say I tap on the battery optimization. So which application is with the battery optimization, everything will be shown here. So as you can see, some of the apps are optimized and some of the apps are not optimized. Now based on that, you can actually change. So unrestricted data access is given to which app. So if you want to know which application has access to what information of yours, you can basically find it here. So you can either allow or even disable right away from here. So this is a special app access menu that can be found inside the settings. Again, going to the additional settings and privacy. So these were the features in this video. In the next video, I'll be covering more features about the Redmi Note 7 Pro. So hit that like button if you want to see these kind of videos, and don't forget to click on that subscribe button if you are new to my channel. All right, guys, see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye bye.